While the world's focus is solely on America, Russia, and China in the fifth-generation fighter jet race, an unexpected new name has emerged: Turkey. A country that was once solely a customer of the F-16 has now launched the KAAN, a sophisticated stealth fighter jet touted as comparable to the F-35 and Su-57. More than just a prestige project, the presence of the KAAN symbolizes the revival of a national defense industry that has long been in the shadow of the world's great powers. Amid geopolitical tensions and the growing need for military independence, Turkey is signaling its readiness to become a major player in the combat technology arena. Is this simply overambitious, or a real threat to global air dominance? After being unilaterally removed from the F-35 program by the United States in 2019 due to its purchase of the Russian S-400 air defense system, Turkey faced a harsh reality. It could no longer rely on its longtime ally to meet its modern air defense needs. However, rather than bowing to Western pressure, Turkey chose a far more challenging path, developing a domestically developed fifth-generation fighter jet. This gave birth to the TFX project, now known as KAAN, a symbol of technological independence and the rise of national air power. Fully supported by Turkish aerospace industries, Thai and local companies such as Aselsan and Havelsan, the KAAN project became a turning point for Turkey's defense industry. The government saw this not only as a military project, but also as a driving force for industrialization and strategic diplomacy. Amidst the global competition between the F-22, F-35, Su-57, and J-20, Turkey insisted that KAAN was not a replacement project, but a real alternative to global air dominance. From its exterior, the KAAN embodies all the hallmarks of a fifth-generation fighter jet. Its body is designed with sharp angles designed to reflect radar signals, shaped air intakes to conceal the engine fans from frontal detection, and a lightweight yet strong composite structure. Internal weapon bays allow weapons to be carried without disrupting the radar silhouette, making the KAAN difficult to detect even by the latest generation of radars. Not only is the KAAN stealthy, but it is also modular in design. This means it can be easily customized for a variety of roles, from air superiority and precision surface strikes to electronic reconnaissance missions. This design makes the KAAN a true multi-role fighter platform, adaptable to the needs of the future battlefield. Interestingly, the KAAN is also designed to be compatible with NATO infrastructure without being completely dependent on American technology. This opens up significant opportunities for Turkey to sell this jet to countries seeking to escape superpower political pressure, while simultaneously expanding Ankara's geopolitical influence through the export of advanced defense equipment. Beneath its futuristic appearance, the KAAN is equipped with world-class avionics technology. The locally manufactured Murad-100A radar is at the heart of the detection and fire control system, providing multi-target detection capabilities in various weather and conditions. This system was developed to simultaneously lock onto and engage air and ground targets at a longer range than conventional radar. What truly sets the KAAN apart is its sensor fusion system, which combines information from the radar, IRS, infrared, search and track, data link, and electro-optical camera. The result is far superior situational awareness, allowing the pilot to see the battlefield in 360-degree digital form, almost like having a sixth sense in the cockpit. Furthermore, the KAAN is designed to control autonomous combat drones such as the Kisilelma or ANKA-3. This integration creates a network-centric warfare system, making the KAAN not just a fighter aircraft, but a digital air command capable of coordinating large-scale air operations in real time. The initial version of the KAAN uses the General Electric F-110 engine, a turbofan also used in the F-16. But Turkey isn't stopping there. They are developing a locally developed high-powered turbofan engine in collaboration with BAE Systems and several Ukrainian partners, designed to enable the aircraft to supercruise, that is, fly supersonic without afterburners, a key feature of fifth-generation jets. The KAAN's performance targets are significant. The aircraft is designed to fly at a maximum speed of Mach 1.8 to Mach 2.0, an operational ceiling of over 55,000 feet, and a range of over 1,100 kilometers in a single mission without refueling. Its maneuverability is further enhanced by a next-generation fly-by-wire system. In addition to speed and cruising range, the KAAN will also be capable of carrying a payload of up to 10 tons, including long-range air-to-air missiles, smart bombs, and electronic warfare equipment. With such capacity and efficiency, the KAAN is targeted to be capable of carrying out long-range combat missions in strategic regions such as the Aegean Sea, the Eastern Mediterranean, and even Central Asia. The KAAN is a highly ambitious project financially. To date, the budget has reached over $1.3 billion, making it one of the largest defense projects in modern Turkish history. However, the government views this as a strategic investment, not a burden. The KAAN is not just a fighter jet, but a symbol of independence and a new diplomatic tool more powerful than any trade agreement. Turkey aims for the KAAN to replace its F-16 fleet in the 2030s. More interestingly, Ankara also intends to sell the KAAN to countries that lack access to the F-35 whether due to embargoes, high costs, or political considerations. Potential markets include Pakistan, Azerbaijan, Qatar, and even several Southeast Asian countries. With a projected price tag significantly lower than the F-35 but with competitive capabilities, the KAAN could be an attractive alternative for developing countries seeking to strengthen their air forces without becoming technologically dependent on a superpower. The KAAN is more than just a fighter. It is a symbol of resistance to the global monopoly of military technology. In Turkey's hands, the KAAN represents a grand ambition to break American and Russian air dominance. The question now is, will the KAAN become a new pioneer of multipolar air power? Or just another expensive dream of a country seeking the global stage?